Loop's financial difficulties arose from a combination of rising maintenance costs, overspending, and lower than normal attendance.
We learned about these things already. French government backed the conglomerate of multinational firms in the year 2094.
The Loop's financial difficulties arose from a combination of rising The four items that the unidentified bidder purchased included the Toltec Mayan ceremonial coffer, King Richard the Lionheart's sword from the Crusades, Leonardo da Vinci's Codex Atlanticus, and an interactive sculpture entitled Self-Awareness, credited to Kenneth Farnstein. Attendees at the auction... Experts estimate that the unidentified man paid at least 7 billion credits more than the true value of the pieces, but none could say why he was so interested in four such disparate artifacts.
I want to know about that. Jade and gold coffer thought to have a role in Mayan religious ceremony discovered in 2027 during an archaeological dig previously undiscovered cavern below the pyramid known as the High Priest's Grave in Chichen Itza. Most distinctive features of its cover are its cylindrical shape and intricate locking mechanism. Let's see. The cover was thought to be cursed, and its first foreigners perished under mysterious circumstances. It is now known that its locking mechanism contains poison needles that jab anyone who attempts to open it without having entered the proper combo. This cover is now better understood. All beliefs and superstitions have dissuaded any further attempts at opening it. Unfortunately, radiography has yielded few clues about its contents of this unique coffer, which currently resides in the Louvre Museum of Art and History. Beautiful sword. Intricate ornamental designs from the very tip, which is elegant and supposed to kill it, which is punctuated with a 4-carat diamond. Freaking big. Taken by Philip Augustus, siege of Chateau Gaillard in 1204. Unearthed almost a millennium later. Of a condemned French chateau. Alright. Contains collected observations on the flight of birds as well as designs for flying machines and other thoughts on how flight can be achieved by humans. They're contained, not capable of flight, however, in this design, the concept would have been seen in working flying machines centuries later. Though denying that Da Vinci must be credited as father of flying machines. Self-awareness. Amorax. Notice that they all came from our locations. Note. Succeeding in what no one to this day has achieved, the creation of true artificial life. Too much crap to read on this stuff. Of itself here, life's sculptures, places herself among the ranks of history's great cartographers of the soul. Holy crap! Alright, and the last one.
The events surrounding the arrest of Agent 5 bring back, for most, memories of the Elliot Sinclair incident. That historic day 10 years ago could have turned out much differently if it weren't for Agent 5 of the Temporal Protectorate. After building the first ever functional time machine, only to have the government shelve the project because it was considered too dangerous, Sinclair decided to sidestep the politicians and build his own temporal transporter. Years later, when the Sirolans made contact with Earth to offer us a place in the symbiotry of peaceful beings, the xenophobic scientist suddenly found himself with a new purpose. Fearing an alien invasion, he tried to convince the public that the Sirolans were not what they appeared to be, but this endeavor met with little success. Frustrated, exasperated, and on the verge of insanity, Sinclair formulated a plan to make Earth a more difficult target for the Sirolans. On the day of the Sirolan ambassador's arrival, he sent each of his three robot minions back in time to change the course of history. The first he sent to create a nuclear scare that would prevent world unification and prolong the Cold War. The second was to destroy the Morimoto Mars colony and make it look like the work of an alien race. And the third, Sinclair sent to kill Dr. Enrique Castillo, the individual who was most influential in convincing humanity of the benefits of joining the symbiotry. His backup plan, should his robots have failed, was to assassinate the Cerulean delegates. It was our good fortune that Agent 5 was on duty at the Temporal Security Annex that day. He detected the temporal distortions, stopped each of the androids, and then apprehended Sinclair himself. That fateful morning made a hero of Agent 5 and spawned the blockbuster holoflick, The Journeyman Project. Elliot Sinclair was put on trial and found guilty of all charges. He was sentenced to life imprisonment on Vega Thallon and hasn't been heard from since.
All right, that's all of our news. We can finally get out of this freaking thing and get back to the game. That was a lot of progress. Make sure I save. Open the door. Description 728-2329. For the past few jumps, I've been experiencing a vague, dizzy sort of feeling when I time travel. It's almost like something hovering just beyond the reach of my consciousness. Could potentially be what Mr. Dotton said. The word on the tip of my tongue, the feeling goes away, and I get to where I'm going, and I haven't experienced it before. Not sure if I'm the only one. Could be some kind of disease. Middle of the loading. Come on, here we go. Does that from time to time. Maybe it's sensitivity to it. I'm not that surprised. No one's ever proven time travel entirely safe, and we're the guinea pigs. Oh, whatever. I'll have to let Shalman know. Personal mission transmission. Transcription, I don't understand it. The coordinates of the station were supposed to be accurate to within a millimeter, but somehow I ended up floating in space where the station had been an hour earlier. I don't remember that. Unless the location and velocity data were wrong, I don't know how it could have been so badly miscalculated. They said it took everything into account down to the most negligible effects on its velocity by any bodies within 1,000 light years of it. I could see the station drifting out there, but I couldn't get to it. The suit doesn't have any kind of thrusters. PC protocol says to scrap a mission if something unpredictable happens. Obviously an error in calculation. I think I'm going to go ahead and try to find a way to get to the station, but if I go in there looking for thrusters, somebody might wonder what's going on. Came up with a pretty cheesy idea for propelling myself to the space station. Hint. Still can't believe it actually worked. Not that it matters. Even after getting in, I kept running into barriers, no oxygen, no gravity, jammed doors, and here's the kicker. I heard a voice. Shouldn't have been anyone in there. Whoever saw me told me to get off the station. I'm not sure how it detected. Live longer than we believe. Was it Arnstein? Don't know. Might it have been an artificial life that he created? Can't escape the irony. I went there to learn the truth, but the truth is what forced me away. Huh. One more page. I don't know about my luck these days. It happened again. When I got to Gaillard, there was someone standing right in front of me. Looking out over the tower, he spun around the second he heard the displacement effect. There wasn't a thing I could do, but before he could even draw a sword, an arrow came over the wall and hit him in the back. Lucky for me, I guess, he would have killed me. Can you imagine the distortion that would have caused? Should have created a huge one as it was. I guess they were just damn lucky that an arrow would have hit him anyway. I don't get it. The jump locations are supposed to be scanned with a fine-tooth comb. How could they have not noticed? You hear their explanation for this one. You watch Philippe Auguste's men climbing up through the guard robe. When I get here, all I see is a grappling hook they left behind. The whole reason I was sent... The guard robe, by the way, is like a toilet. The whole reason I was sent there was to document how the castle fell, and they got me too late. It's difficult to distill information from historical accounts, but this is twice in many missions. I'll talk with the guys in the research before I materialize in the middle of a Shriner's convention. My last jump, strange feeling I've been experiencing during time travel came a little more tangible. I became aware of a faint, almost imperceptible ghost image about my jumpsuit floating slightly out of phase of myself. I'm assuming it's a glitch in the suit's circuitry. The time phase synchronizer is possibly malfunctioning. That should work.